For nearly half a century, astronomers have told us that Jupiter's moon Io is the most volcanically active body in the solar system. In 1979, NASA's Voyager spacecraft imaged for the first time enormous plumes jetting up to hundreds of kilometers above the moon's surface. Planetary scientists have long since settled on the consensus theory that, quote, gravitational kneading by the moon's gas giant parent creates internal tidal heating, thus causing the volcanic eruptions. However, as soon as the so-called volcanic plumes were imaged, some scientists noticed features that are totally incompatible with the volcanism hypothesis. Most curious of all was the filamentary structure in the plumes, which to this day has no explanation in standard geology. Indeed, in 1979, the renowned astronomer Thomas Gold proposed in the scientific paper, Electrical Origin of the Outbursts on Io, that the explosively jetted material on Io is the result of high-energy electrical discharge. In 1987, Dr. Anthony Peratt of Los Alamos Laboratories and co-author Alex Dessler co-authored their own peer-reviewed paper, in which they proposed that the filamentation in the plumes finds a perfect laboratory analog in a device called the plasma gun. Unfortunately, to this day, planetary scientists seem completely unaware of Peratt and Dessler's thesis, which remains the only peer-reviewed paper to successfully explain the plume's filamentary structures. With increasingly fine technological data, we in the Electric Universe community only expect further confirmation of the electrical hypothesis. Such apparent confirmation has come recently thanks to NASA's Juno spacecraft, which has detected what investigators refer to as the most intense volcanic eruption ever recorded. As noted in a press release from JPL, NASA's Juno spacecraft has uncovered an immense volcanic hotspot on Jupiter's moon Io, surpassing any previously recorded eruptions in the solar system. This fiery inferno radiates over 80 trillion watts and dwarfs the infamous Loki Patera, even by the standards of Io, the most volcanic celestial body in the solar system. Recent events observed on the Jovian moon are extreme. A Science Alert article notes the intensity of the so-called eruptions as follows. In its latest flyby, the orbiter imaged a volcanic hotspot on the moon's south pole, larger than Lake Superior. According to NASA, the hotspot's eruptions are 6 times more energetic than all of Earth's power plants, and its radiance measured well above 80 trillion watts. Now, one might think that 80 trillion watts produced by a discharge the size of Lake Superior might provide investigators a clue as to the phenomenon's electrical nature. Again, an experimentally supported hypothesis published in a major peer-reviewed journal. However, the official interpretation of these electrical discharges remains volcanism as a result of, quote, tidal flexing. While NASA investigators may have no interest in the Peratt-Dessler paper, they may need to be brought up to speed on what science discovery has been telling us in recent years about the hypothesis of volcanism on Io. Over a decade ago, a survey of Io's internal heat signature found that the location of the so-called volcanic plumes on Io are completely incompatible with patterns predicted by the tidal heating model. As noted in the April 4, 2013 NASA JPL press release, scientists to Io, volcanoes are in the wrong spot. Unexpected locations of volcanoes provide a clue that we don't fully understand Jupiter's moon Io. Researcher Christopher Hamilton stated, "We performed the first rigorous statistical analysis of the distribution of volcanoes in the new global geologic map of Io. We found a systematic eastward offset between observed and predicted volcano locations that can't be reconciled with any existing solid body tidal heating models. A clue to the electrical origins of the Io plumes is found in the following statements in the JPL press release. Galileo's magnetometer instrument detected a magnetic field around Io, suggesting the presence of a global subsurface magma ocean. As Io orbits Jupiter, it moves inside the planet's vast magnetic field. Researchers think this could induce a magnetic field in Io if it had a global ocean of electrically conducting magma. However, like the tidal heating models of Io, this theory has also been discredited by science discovery. As noted in the December 17, 2024 Science Alert article, Jupiter's hellish moon isn't powered by a hidden ocean of magma. Jupiter's moon Io is the most volcanically active body in our solar system, with around 400 volcanoes and extensive lava flows spread across its surface. But contrary to what scientists thought, a new study suggests this geological chaos is not powered by a global, moon-wide ocean of magma below the surface. In light of these findings, investigators propose that, quote, magma chambers rather than a magma ocean fuel the so-called volcanic eruptions. We have often said that prediction is the ultimate test of any theory's credibility. And indeed, the Jovian moon has now consistently provided one of the clearest successes for the electric universe theory. In the mid-1990s, prior to NASA's Galileo mission, physicist Wal Thornhill registered several advanced claims. Following the lead of Gold, Peratt, and Dessler, Thornhill proposed that the, quote, volcanic plumes are in fact electrical discharge. He predicted the so-called volcanic vents would be much hotter than lava. The plumes are the jets of cathode arcs, and they do not explode from a volcanic vent, but instead move around and erode the periphery of dark areas, which planetary geologists call lava lakes. The, quote, lava lakes themselves are the solid surface of Io, etched electrically by cathode arcs. They would not reveal the expected heat of a recent lava flow. Each of these predictions received stunning confirmation. The so-called volcanic hotspots were not only hotter than any lava on Earth, but were too hot to be measured by Galileo's instruments. Indeed, no lava flow ever recorded has produced temperatures as hot as seen in the original Galileo image. Also as predicted by Thornhill, the discharging was found to be focused on the edges of the so-called lava lakes, though the rest of those dark fields are comparatively cold. None of the expected volcanic vents could be found. And in fact, some of the, quote, volcanic plumes were discovered to move across the surface of Io. Equally as telling, it was also discovered that the plumes emit ultraviolet light, something totally inconceivable under normal conditions of volcanic venting. But ultraviolet light is, of course, characteristic of an electric arc. We must also note, the findings by NASA's Juno mission have completely upended the conventional models of the Jovian environment. Investigators were stunned when they discovered that Jupiter's colossal magnetic field is twice as powerful as had been previously estimated. Further, the magnetic field is much more irregular than models had suggested, raising serious questions about the hypothetical, quote, dynamo action thought to take place in the planet's interior. Further still, the decades-long mystery of enigmatic X-ray flares in Jupiter's polar aurorae was illuminated in 2021 with the discovery of, quote, planetary-size electromagnetic waves, which appear inextricably linked to the X-ray pulses. Make no mistake, the predictive foundation for the electric universe's theoretical modeling of Jupiter has never been more powerful. The core principle of this foundation is: incoming Birkeland currents from the Sun, which enter at the poles of Jupiter, are what drive the gas giant's auroras, jet streams, intense atmospheric and upper atmospheric phenomena, and its colossal magnetic field. The cathodic electrical discharges we see on Io are comparable to those we see on a comet as it moves from the outer reaches of the solar system into the Sun's electromagnetic domain. The electric current system connecting Jupiter and Io is recognized by mainstream science. However, as always in the space sciences, weird gravitational and magnetic processes are thought to be the drivers of the electrical phenomena. The Birkeland currents that connect the Sun and Jupiter are most emphatically demonstrated by the mysterious fixed cyclones at each of the planet's poles. Nothing in the standard theoretical toolkits of atmospheric and planetary science predicted nor explained the phenomena. As described in a 2022 phys.org report, photos of the planet's north pole show that there are 8 cyclones surrounding the central cyclone directly over the pole. All 8 are in close proximity, and all are nearly equidistant from the central cyclone, and are arranged in an octagonal pattern. At this time, it is not clear if the cyclones rotate around the center. There is a similar arrangement at the southern pole, only there are just 5 cyclones, shaped as a pentagon. The report acknowledges, such behavior is of course unheard of here on Earth. Cyclones take shape, travel around for a while, and then dissipate. Such behavior has left researchers scrambling to come up with a reasonable explanation for what they have observed. The investigators propose that, quote, an anticyclonic ring of winds that move in the opposite direction of the cyclones is what keeps them in place. The irony of this proposal was not lost to many of us in the Electric Universe community, since we're aware of the groundbreaking work of Thunderbolt's colleague, Dr. Donald E. Scott. It was a few years ago that Dr. Scott first published his mathematical modeling of the structure of a Birkeland current, which is visualized as counter-rotating cylindrical shells. In past interviews, Dr. Scott noted that counter-rotational patterns are seen in the vortexes at the poles of both of the gas giants, Jupiter and Saturn. Indeed, the counter-rotational wind movements associated with Jupiter's cyclones is not surprising if incoming Birkeland currents are contributing to the phenomena. As we've exhaustively explained in the past, hexagons and other polygonal or octagonal forms are produced in plasma discharge. Consider the side-by-side images on your screen. On the left are vortices of an electron beam, etched onto a carbon witness plate. On the right are vortices of an electron beam, photographed on a fluorescent screen. It's also worth noting here that the attempts to explain the famous hexagons at each of Saturn's poles by simple fluid dynamics has also been falsified by science discovery. In 2018, scientists using images obtained by NASA's Cassini spacecraft observed an unexpected, towering vortex far above the famous hexagon. A Science Alert report on the observation stated, "There's something strange over Saturn's north pole. A tremendous structure towering high above the clouds indicates that the planet's peculiar hexagonal formation is much, much bigger than was initially apparent," one investigator said of the discovery. "As the polar vortex became more and more visible, we noticed it had hexagonal edges and realized that we were seeing the pre-existing hexagon at much higher altitudes than previously thought." The problematic nature of this discovery is noted in the Science Alert article, which states, "Since wind conditions change dramatically with altitude, the fact that the hexagon shape persists so much higher than the cloud tops is a baffling conundrum." A considerably more baffling conundrum is, with the 21st century now nearly one quarter complete, why does the causative role of electric currents in the cosmos remain verboten in the space sciences? Thank you.